Hey, welcome back to my new video. This is Easy Tutorials, and for those of you who are the first time in this channel, please consider subscribing. Today we'll be creating watercolor transitions like in the following example, using the paricular plugin. Before we start, I'd like to invite you to support me on Patreon. You can also get access to all my premium content. In this tutorial, we'll be using the Easy Tool script, which is free to download. You can get it by clicking the link from the upper right corner of this screen. You can also download the project files and the template separately. This way you will be able to create this wonderful watercolor transitions. Even if you don't want to download my template, you can find the download links in the description. So let's start. Import the files you need into After Effects. First, we'll have to animate the watercolor stain. In order to do this, let's create a new composition. Name it Stain. Make it 500 by 500 pixels. And 6 seconds long. Bring the watercolor stain file inside this composition. You can use any other watercolor stain image, if you don't like this particular one. Move to the third second, open the scale property, and create a keyframe. Move back 1 second, open the opacity property and create a keyframe. Move back to the beginning of your timeline, and change the opacity value to 0%. Open the scale again, and change both values to 0%. Reveal all the keyframes, select them and easy ease them. Then, open the graph editor, select these two keyframes, and drag their handles all the way to the left. Your stain animation should look like this. Create a new composition and name it Watercolor Transition. Let's make it 1920 by 1080 pixels and 10 seconds long. Bring the stain composition inside of it and make it invisible. Create a new solid layer and name it Transition. Go to your Effects and Presets panel, search for Paricular, and apply it to your transition layer. The default particles will be spheres. To change it, open the Particle tab and change the particle type to Sprite. Open the texture, and change the layer to the stain layer. Here, you will also have to change the time sampling to start at birth, play once. To give it a more random look, open the rotation, and change the random rotation value to 100. Make the life value 6, the same value as the stain animation length. And the size 300. Your animation should look like this, until now. As you can see, all the particles starts from the same point. To change it, open the emitter tab. And change the emitter type to box. Switch emitter size to individual axes. Change the X value to 1920. The Y value to 1080. And the Z value to 0. Change the particle number to 50, and let's preview the animation. As you can see, the particles are moving around a little. To stop the movement, change the velocity value to 0. The watercolor transition will look like this. If you don't like this pattern, you only have to change the random seed value. This way you will be able to create an infinite number of unique transitions. Now, let's see how to use our transition. I will create a new composition, named example, using the same settings as before. Create a solid layer and name it BG. Apply the fill effect to it, and change the fill color to a very light gray. This will be our background. Bring the first footage inside this composition, and place the watercolor transition layer on top of it. Go to the track matte panel. If you can't see it here, click his icon to make it visible. Change the footage track matte to alpha matte, and you have created your transition. To use it multiple times, bring the second footage inside the composition. If you want to use a different pattern, select the watercolor transition layer from the project panel, and duplicate it. Open it, select the transition layer and change the random seed value as we did before. Bring the new transition on top of the new footage. Offset both layers around 5 seconds. And change the track matte of your footage to alpha matte. Let's check our final result. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial on how to create watercolor transitions in After Effects. Don't forget to subscribe, hit the like button and comment. It would be great to know your opinions on my tutorials. Also, you can make requests for new tutorials on interesting effects or animations that you would like to learn. See you soon.